Hi, my name is Howie Brounstein, and I'm with Columbine School of Botanical Studies, along with...
Stephen Yeager, from the Columbine School of Botanical Studies.
And we're here on behalf of Mountain Rose Herbs to bring you a piece of this. The meadows at middle elevations in the Western Oregon Cascades.
Okay, here we are with our next plant here. We have a plant called Paintbrush, which comes in all colors. There's many different paintbrushes in the Pacific Northwest. They're in the genus Castilleja, and they're in the family Orobanchaceae. And yeah, paintbrush, and they have all different colors. They'll be yellow, red, pinkish, even
green.
Green.
Yep. Yeah.
And the colored part, the part that's really attractive and showy, are actually not flowers at all. They're bracts. Bracts are modified leaves.
The flowers aren't red?
Nope. In this case, the flowers are not red. Those are showy bracts. They still may serve the same purpose of attracting pollinators, like a showy petal might. But these showy parts are actually bracts. But the flowers are actually this greenish part here, and much more inconspicuous than the bracts. Another thing about the Castilleja and Orobanchaceae, Orobanchaceae's are mostly partially parasitic, meaning that their roots have a structure on them called haustoria that actually attach to roots of other plants growing around it. And so they partially get the nutrients and perhaps water that they need from these other plants, making them partially parasitic.
Are you saying that these plants are cheese-sucking parasites?
Cheese-sucking parasites?
Yeah.
Yeah. I guess that's one way to put it, Howie.
But they're only partially parasitic because they do have green. They do have chlorophyll. So they do make energy from the sun. They do the solar energy, the change that plants often do. We would say in Bonnie Land that these leaves are chlorophyllous. They're actually chlorophyllous leaves, but they do attach sometimes to other plants and suck their chi. That makes certain species of paintbrushes difficult to grow in your garden unless you have the right companion plant. Some species seem to grow just fine in gardens. I find this very interesting and very unique. I love paintbrushes. I know that here in the Pacific Northwest, if you look at from San Francisco to Alaska, we are the center of biodiversity for Castillejas or paintbrushes, which means we have many different kinds here. One of the things I find interesting about paintbrushes is that they concentrate toxins. Most plants, if they're growing in a soil that has toxins, have filters on their roots to prevent these toxins from being sucked up into the plant. But paintbrushes are known to actually suck up and concentrate many kinds of environmental toxins, making the plant even more toxic than the dirt around it. So even though you may see sometimes in some places that these paintbrushes are edible, it's unwise to do that because even a naturally occurring, for example, more arid soil that has a toxic arsenic or selenium might be concentrated into these and make these plants poisonous. So in general, you can't really eat them. In general, you'd have to consider them poisonous unless you knew you were in a pristine spot.
Well, that sure has been a lot of fun, Howie.
Sure has. It's time for us to go, but be safe and interact with plants.
We'll see you next time.